हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास सिक्स, वेलकम्स टू डीवी मॉयल पब्लिक स्कूल ऑनलाइन लर्निंग क्लास। आई एम योर सोशल साइंस टीचर मनीष सावड़े। डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडेज टॉपिक इज द स्माइलिंग फेस ऑफ आवर कंट्री। हियर इज द टॉपिक फ्रॉम इंडिया माई मदरलैंड। डियर स्टूडेंट, हियर द लैंड फीचर्स। The land features the physical division of India: the Himalayan mountain, the Great Plain of North India, the coastal plain and island. Today we are going to learn about the northern plain. Here dear student, in this map you are seeing the area of the northern plain in our country. To the south of Shivalik Range, the Great Northern Plain extend from Punjab to Assam. Dear student, you can see this picture shows you the area of Northern Plain. Means from Punjab, extend from Punjab to Assam. They are made up fine silt brought down by rivers from Himalayas in the north and the plateau in the south. This is a low-lying flat and uniform land. Dear student, this northern plain has been formed by Ganga and the Brahmaputra rivers and their several tributaries. We know the rivers which join a major rivers are called the tributaries. So dear student, this is the northern plain. River Satluj is the longest river, and River Satluj is the longest tributary of the Indus system. Ganga basin is the largest basin of India, and Yamuna river is the longest tributary which joins it at Allahabad, known as Sangam. Here dear student, the picture of Sangam, Allahabad. Here the Yamuna river is Ganga's longest tributary which join it at Allahabad, known as Sangam. This is the Sangam place at Allahabad. Dear student, Ganga and Brahmaputra rivers form a great delta. Ganga and Brahmaputra rivers form a great delta, the biggest in the world, before falling into Bay of Bengal. This delta has triangular shape. Okay, this delta has triangular shape, and it is low-lying area where the major rivers are split into several channels. This delta region near the sea is called Sundarban. You are seeing the picture of Sundarban, dear student. You are seeing the picture of Sundarban Delta. So, it is all about the Northern Plain. Northern Plains have all ideal condition to attract human settlement. They are the biggest producer of food grains. Therefore, this plain is densely populated. We know that Northern Plains is densely populated area in our country. So dear student, it is all about the northern plain. Now we are moving on now the desert. You are seeing the map of India and the locations of the desert in our country. Here the red color shows you, dark red color shows you the desert, area of desert. The Thar Desert, a rocky and sandy area, covers a large part of Rajasthan to the west of the Aravali mountain range. It is an arid land with very high temperature and little annual rainfall. The desert has a scanty natural vegetation such as cactus and acacia. You can see, this is the desert and there are some cactus plant and some scanty natural vegetation is there. Okay, it is all about a desert. Now the next part is the Great Plateau. When we move towards the south from the Great Plain, there is a triangular landmass. It is known as the Great Peninsular Plateau. You are seeing the picture of the Great Peninsular Plateau. Okay? This is the map of India showing you the Great Peninsular Plateau. It's the northern part known as the Central Highland. Okay? This is the Central Highland, dear student. This is the Central Highland. Okay? This is Central Highland of Peninsular Plateau. Okay? It comprises of the Aravalli Mountains and the Vindhya Mountains and several small plateaus extending from the west to east. So, it is the Central Highland. Now, the Narmada and Tapi River, lying to the south of Vindhyas, flow westward into the Arabian Sea. The southern part of the plateau is called the Deccan Plateau. Dear student, here our Deccan Plateau is there. The red mark, red circle shows you in the south, it's a Deccan Plateau. The southern part of the plateau is called the Deccan Plateau. It is triangular in shape. The western ghats run along the coast of Arabian Sea. Now, here, the western ghats, this part is the western ghats, okay? And this is your eastern ghats of the plateau. The eastern ghats run along the coast of Bay of Bengal. These mountains are cut by rivers in several places. And entire plateau region is rich in a mineral. So, this is all about the Peninsular Plateau. Now, here the Central Highland and the Deccan Plateau. You are seeing the picture of Central Highland and Deccan Plateau. Dear student, I hope you understand today's topic. So, here is some assignment question for you on today's topic. You should write these questions in your notebook and write its answer properly. Okay, dear student, I hope you understand today's topic. Thank you for today and thank you for making us a part of your day. Thank you, dear student. We will meet in next period with a new topic. Thank you for today.